गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके सो वी स्टार्ट विद आवर यूनिट नंबर 4। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड 3 यूनिट्स, सो वी स्टार्ट विद नंबर 4। व्हाट इज योर फोर्थ यूनिट?
लैपलेस।
राइट, सो लैपलेस ट्रांसफॉर्म्स। राइट द यूनिट नंबर 4, स्टार्ट राइटिंग next unit, Laplace transforms. So we start with the definition of Laplace transforms. It can be like Laplace transforms or LT. These are all notations, Laplace transforms. So it is denoted by, if once we are starting with Laplace transform, we should see the notation first and then we'll go to the definition. So it is denoted by L of some function, say f of t, L of square bracket, or it can also be denoted by L of curly bracket of some function. So generally we prefer square bracket, and is defined as if f of t is any function of, if f of t is any function of the variable t, okay, any function, it can be any function but with certain conditions. So with certain conditions where it should be defined or not. With certain conditions, then the integral definition is an integration. Then the integral, if it exists, that integration exists, is called the Laplace transform. Laplace transform of the function f of t. Of f of t, that is, we know the definition notation is L of f of t. Okay, this is the notation and is defined as it is integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into f of t, this f of t dt. So Laplace of any function f of t is that f of t will be given to you and it will ask to find the Laplace of that function, right? Then it is integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st, this is the operator, into your given function with respect to t. That is what is the definition of Laplace transform of the function given f of t. Okay, so if you are asked, use the formula, solve the integration, and you'll get the answer. So before we go with this, we should see some notes. So first note is like Laplace transform converts or transforms a function in variable t, right? Function is in variable t into another variable. So if you solve this integration, it is with respect to t. So here t get removes and everything will become s. So we are writing about variable. So Laplace transforms convert a function in variable t into the another variable, say s. So what the Laplace transform does is actually the domain transfer, that is domain transfer, a transform from T to S. It works as a transformer. So whenever, if you want to transform one domain to another, you have to apply the function inside, is called Laplace transform. So here it transforms T to S. So like if you are transforming one variable into another or one domain into another, can you see any of the day-to-day life example where domain transform is we can see? Like one domain is transforming to other, like electricity is transformed to something, or some energy is transforming into other energy. Is there any such example in our day-to-day life? Where transforms we can see, wherever transformers are used, na, inside you have seen or you have heard somewhere in your house, transformer, these words. So wherever transformers are there, they do something, they transform one domain into another domain. So you have heard about motors in your farms, there are motors. Or a very recent example, you can see air conditioners, ACs, or refrigerators, right? What is the function inside is domain transform. So electricity is getting converted into whatever we need. So in case of air conditioners, if we need the temperature, so it just adjusts the temperature, where domain transform happens. A function in one domain gets converted into the other domain. That is called the transforms. And the main function inside ACs or any of these transformers are Laplace transforms. Okay, are you getting what I mean to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, so it is actually a transformer and it converts one domain into the other domain. So we are just seeing if one function is there, if we use the Laplace transform, to where it just convert, what is that extent? Like if we have the value of t also, and if we have the value of s also, we can found the easily find out the transformers means where it get converted, its efficiency or whatever. Chal. So what happens here is a domain transform function from a variable t to another variable s. Second note. So whenever we apply this formula, Laplace of f of t is integration 0 to infinity. This is the formula you have to remember. E raised to minus st f of t dt. If you solve this, whatever is the answer, that will be in s only. So whatever is its answer, it will have only the variable s, t will get removed, everything will be s. So we can call this as Laplace of f of t is say f of s. Here we have used small f, and that's why we are using capital F this side. But here is the function t, and here is the function s. Okay, so next note is some authors use f of s as phi of s. This is the notation only, so they can use f, they can use phi, whatever. And also they can use p. P is also used in place of s. So if you can see somewhere in your gate or in higher studies, these are the variables, then just get confused. Do not get confused in that, like if it is phi of s instead of f of s, or p in case of s, okay. You just change the variables. It is the matter of variables only. So in whatever we are going to see in this unit is this only, capital F of s and s, not p. Please remember, this is what we are seeing. Good, so these are the notes, and then I'll just write formula once and we'll start with the examples. Formula I'm writing once again, Laplace of the function f of t is integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into that f of t dt. Chalo, so we start with the example, find the Laplace transform of. Find the Laplace transform of f of t is given to you is t when function is in 0 to 4 and 5 when t is greater than 4. Read the question was. Question is find the Laplace transform of the function f of t. So we know the formula. What the formula is? Laplace of f of t is, you should write it first. And please remember, integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus s t f of t dt. Right? So if you want to find this Laplace transform of the given function, you should find the integration and you'll get the answer. Right? But the integration is 0 to infinity. Integration depends on the function f of t. But f of t here get breaks. How is the function breaks here in two intervals? What is the first interval?
0 to 4.
Right, 0 to 4. And second is?
Greater than 4.
Greater than 4 means 4 to infinity. Upper limit is not fixed. So t starts with 4 and goes up to infinity. So if the intervals break for the function, so here integration depends on the function. That's why integration also breaks. What breaks means? Like this. Two times it will be there and there will be addition in between. So first it breaks as 0 to 4. So integration limits are 0 to 4. And secondly, it is 4 to above means 4 to infinity. Upper limit is not fixed. Right. E raised to minus st is the operator. In both the cases, it is there. Into f of t. So in 0 to 4, what is f of t?
T.
It is t. In 0 to 4, your function is t. So it is e raised to minus st into f of t. In 0 to 4, it is t into dt. And in 4 to infinity, this part is there. We have written. And in 4 to infinity, the function is?
5.
Right. This is 4 to infinity and function here is 5. So 5 dt. DSY students are getting?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Good. So yes, we have to find the integrations. Your 5 is constant in multiplication. So 5 just comes out. This is as it is there, t into e raised to minus st dt. Plus your 5 just comes out, integration 4 to infinity e raised to minus st dt. Now integration e, now for DSY students, it's very important now for you. Ahat ka ikde, let me just check.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for DSY students, we need some formulae now, like derivative, integrations. And this formulae we have written in our very first, second, third lecture maybe. First was just introduction. So you can check the lecture notes there in your study material provided. You will go through the formulae now. Okay. What are the derivatives? What are the integrations? Because I'm writing integrations now. In this case, and you might don't know the integration. So in this case, please today you will go with the formula. You will write it down and remember them. So here we have to find here integration of E. So do you know the integration of E?
Yes.
Formula, what is integration E raised to AX dx?
E raised to AX upon A.
Right. Integration of E raised to AX is E itself upon derivative of that AX with respect to X, it is A. Okay. And what is the derivative of E raised to AX?
E raised to AX into A.
Right. Derivative of E is E itself. And in case of derivative, this is getting multiplied. And in case of integration, this A is getting divided. Please remember. So some formulae we'll write. So I'll write it here. Derivative of sine. What is the derivative of sine?
Cos.
Cos. Cos AX into A. What is integration of sine?
Minus cos A.
Minus cos AX upon A. This A is here multiplied. This A is here divides. So next we want is cos AX. What is integration of cos?
Minus sine.
Minus of sine AX into
A.
A, so minus A sine X. And integration of cos X is?
Sine X.
Sine X. Integration of cos is sine, while derivative of cos is minus sine. Sine AX upon A. Right. Please remember this, we'll need them. And one more very important is, here integration e we can write, but if two functions are multiplied, it is e into t. How will you solve this integration? But before that, for DSY students, so it is integration u into v. If you want to solve this, till now you have used by parts, integration by parts, right? So here, what was the formula for that? U into integration v minus integration of derivative u into integration v. This was the formula. And by using that formula, you will never get the integration that early, like what we are going to do now. So this rule is very important. Mizo ata sangnar ahe. Leibniz rule, it is called for integration. And the whole Fourier series depends on this rule. So DSY students and regular students also, please pay the attention for some time. So we are not going to use these byparts. We'll see integration of two functions if they are multiplying by Leibniz rule. So I'll explain the rule to you now. Please pay attention, Leibniz rule. We'll take it forward. Leibniz rule of integration. So when there are two functions multiplied together. Okay, so integration, suppose there are two multiplies u and v, then you can write the formula as u v1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4 plus so on. Okay, remember the formula. Integration u into v is u first into v1, then here is plus, no need to write, then minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, alternate plus minus signs. Then whatever is here term, it's derivative here. And whatever is v1, v2 is here. Next, it's derivative here. Okay, next dash here, next number here, next dash here, next number here. So now I'll tell you what is dash and what is that number, okay? So here, dashes, whatever is the dash means like dash, double dash, triple dash, that denotes derivatives. And suffixes means 1, 2, 3, 4, that denotes integration. Okay, so here u dash, first derivative, double derivative, triple derivative, first integration, second, third, fourth integration means next integration. Okay, so now you should choose, okay, and v also. So the for that choice of u and v, u is a derivable function. Derivable manje jyacha derivative ghyayla yayla pahije. U is a derivable function whose derivative will be zero after some derivatives. That's a derivative kadhi tari zero hoil. That function is called u, and v is an integrable function. That's a derivative vagere aplala zero noko hai, v cha. ते फक्त इंटिग्रेबल असलं पाहिजे, जसं इंटिग्रेशन घेता आलं पाहिजे. ओके, सो आर यू गेटिंग, दिस इज द इंटिग्रेशन, अँड इफ यू यूज दिस फॉर्म्युला यू विल गेट इंटिग्रेशन इन ओनली अ सिंगल लाईन. ओके, सो देअर वी नीड अ चॉईस ऑफ यू अँड व्ही. मग यू कुणाला म्हणायचं, व्ही कुणाला म्हणायचं, हे तुम्ही ठरवायचं. यू असं फंक्शन असेल की ज्या फंक्शनचं डेरिव्हेटिव्ह काही डेरिव्हेटिव्ह नंतर, फर्स्ट, सेकंड, थर्ड, फोर्थ, कुठेतरी झिरो होईल. अँड व्ही असं फंक्शन आहे की ज्याचं इंटिग्रेशन घेता येईल. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट दिस फंक्शन एक्स स्क्वेअर कॉस एक्स डी एक्स. सो हिअर टू फंक्शन्स आर मल्टिप्लाय, वन इज यू, वन इज व्ही. सो नाव नो वन विल रेग्युलर स्टुडंट स्पीक नाव. आय आस्क दिस टू डायरेक्ट सेकंड इयर. सो येस, टू फंक्शन्स आर मल्टिप्लाय, वी हॅव दिस रूल where u into v are there, two functions are multiplied, you can use Leibniz rule, right? So in this case, what will be your u? U हे डेरिवेटिव ज्याचं घेता येईल आणि ज्याचं डेरिवेटिव झिरो होईल काही डेरिवेटिव नंतर त्या फंक्शनला यू म्हणायचं. मग या दोघांमध्ये ऑल डीएसवाय आर स्पीकिंग ओनली.
येस मॅम.
राईट. सो व्हॉट इज युअर यू?
एक्स स्क्वेअर.
एक्स स्क्वेअर, व्हेरी गुड. बिकॉज व्हॉट इज द फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव्ह ऑफ एक्स स्क्वेअर?
टू
एक्स. व्हेरी गुड. व्हॉट इज द नेक्स्ट डेरिवेटिव्ह ऑफ दिस टू एक्स? टू. अँड व्हॉट इज द नेक्स्ट डेरिवेटिव्ह ऑफ टू?
झिरो.
झिरो. राईट. सो येस, डेरिवेटिव्ह ऑफ दॅट एक्स स्क्वेअर इज गेटिंग झिरो. दॅट्स वाय दिस इज युअर यू. डेरिवेटिव्ह झिरो होतोय. व्हेरी गुड. अँड व्ही इज अन इंटिग्रेबल फंक्शन. व्ही चं इंटिग्रेशन घेता यावं. कॉस्ट इंटिग्रेशन घेता येतं आपल्याला. येस, यू कॅन टेक द इंटिग्रेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट. व्हेरी गुड. सो येस, वी हॅव चूज यू अँड व्ही. आर यू अँड व्ही आर फिक्स. सो दॅट्स वाय वी कॅन यूज दिस फॉर्म्युला. इफ डेरिवेटिव्ह इज नॉट गेटिंग झिरो फॉर एनी ऑफ द फंक्शन देन वी कॅनॉट यूज लेबनीज रूल. प्लीज रिमेंबर, one of the function's derivative must be zero. Good. So now rule says write u first as it is. Whatever is your u, write it as it is. So u is x square into v1. V1 is 1, 2, 3. These are the integration. V1 is v's first integration. This is your v. So what is the integration of cos? Just now I have written integration of cos.
Minus sine x.
No, derivative is minus sine. Integration is sine ax. A is here 1 upon 1. Sine x only. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. U v1 done. Then negative sine in between. U, first is positive, then negative. So minus sine there. And then u dash. U dash means derivative of this function. Derivative of this function. What is the derivative?
2x.
2x. Very good. Into v2. V2 is its next integration. So integration of this function. What is the integration of sine?
Cos.
It is minus cos.
Please minus attention, cos.
Right. You have to see them some formulae. Right. U v1 minus u dash v2. Then there is a plus sign. Plus u double dash means its next derivative. So its next derivative.
2.
Very good. And into its next integration. What is the next integration of this? Minus sign is there.
Minus sign.
Integration of cos is sine. Minus sign as it is. Good. Next is minus sign minus derivative of this. 2's derivative?
0.
So whenever we get 0, it stops there itself. If 0 comes, it overs, and this is the total integration. Done. DSY students are getting?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Because regular student knows this. We have seen one whole unit Fourier series on this, and you will also have to see that. So that's why I request you to get it clear. That's why I pay that much attention on it. It's important. So is that clear to everyone from DSY? Is there any doubt? Please ask. For that, तुम्हाला डेरिव्हेटिव्ह इंटिग्रेशनचे फॉर्म्युले हवे असणार आहेत. आज तुम्ही जाल स्टडी मटेरियल मध्ये ते पाहाल, लिहून घ्याल आणि लक्षात ठेवा. ओके, सो दिस इज हाऊ इट अप्लाइज. राईट. अँड इट स्टार्ट्स विथ दिस हिअर. सो दिस इज युअर एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल हिअर. सो लेट मी जस्ट नोट इन बिटवीन इट स्टार्टेड ओनली. सो इट हिअर एंड्स. Right, we now go to our question. A question was here. We are writing Laplace of f of t is equal to integration 0 to infinity t e raised to minus st dt plus 5 integration. It was 0 to 4, no? Just take once. 0 to?
Yes, ma'am.
4. Right, 0 yes, to 4. And 4 to infinity e raised to minus st dt. Is this correct? Yes, right. So here is only one function, we can take the integration directly. But here are two functions and we have to solve. So how can we solve? No one regular student will pick. How will you solve this integration? There are two functions multiplied together of t. One function, second function. Two functions are multiplied. So what can we use and solve this integration? I request my regular students do not speak. TSY students, how will you solve this integration? Can we apply Leibniz for this integration?
Yes, ma'am.
If two functions are multiplied together, we can always think of Leibniz rule. Okay. So that is the formula I written. U into V, two functions are multiplied. Two functions are multiplied. Here are also two functions multiplied, but it is in T. Do not get confused. That was in X. It is in T. Just the variable change. This is one function of T. This is other function of T. Two functions multiplied. This is dt. Like what? It is dx, na? So that is your dt. And whenever integration comes, always with respect to comes. So here are these two functions of T. So we are using Leibniz rule. For Leibniz rule, you should always write u and v. So u, what is your u here? In between these two functions, what is u and what is v?
T is u.
Yeah, right?
And e raised to minus
u. And the remaining is v. Why that t is u? We are with respect to t. Remember that. What is the derivative of t with respect to t?
1.
1. What is the next derivative of 1?
0.
0. Yes, it is getting 0. That's why this is your first function u. And the second function is integrable. We can take integration of e. So both the condition obeys. Right? Derivative of the first function is getting zero. That's why this is your u, this is your v. Right. So integration u v. What is the formula I'll write here? U v1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4 minus plus so. So you are writing as it is. So t as it is into v1 integration of e. What is integration of e?
E raised to st yes, upon
integration
s.
Of e, I have written here. E is e itself upon that a. So what is it here? E raised to
minus st.
Minus st upon derivative of this minus st with respect to t. Or just the constant. What is it here?
Just the constant.
Minus s. Because we are with respect to t. Then what sign? Negative. U dash, its derivative. What is the derivative of t?
1.
1. Into integration of this. What is integration? Integration of e again because s is constant.
Yes.
So derivative integration we are taking with respect to t only. T is only the variable. S is constant. This is as it is. So integration of e is e again. E raised to minus st upon minus s.
Minus s.
But already there was one minus s. So minus s into minus s?
S square.
S square. Right. Then minus done, then plus derivative of 1. That will be
0.
0. And this is over. All DSY students are getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any doubt? You can ask me. Okay, so now we are writing this integration e. What is the integration e? It is single function, simpler. No two are multiplied, simple e raised to minus st. So integration is e raised to integration e. We have written it here, no? Integration e raised to minus st upon minus s. This is from 4 to infinity. Okay, so now it's over. Integration is over. But limits we have to write, right? Limits are given, so we should apply them. This is upper limit, this is lower limit. आधी आपण अप्पर लिमिट सगळ्या ठिकाणी ठेवायचं, कुणाच्या जागेवर ठेवायचं, ज्याच्या सोबत इंटिग्रेशन आहे ना. येस, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू व्हॉट इट इज, इट इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टी. सो वी शुड राईट लिमिट्स ओव्हर टी. जर तुम्ही इथे डी एक्स असता ना, तर आपण एक्सच्या जागेवर लिमिट्स ठेवले असते. विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू इथे डी एस असता, तर एसच्या जागेवर ठेवले असते. रिमेंबर, डी टी आहे म्हणजे टी व्हेरिएबल आहे, तुम्ही टीच्या जागेवर लिमिट्स ठेवायचे. पहिला ठेवणारे तुम्ही फोर सगळ्या टीच्या जागी. सो फोर इंटू ई रेस टू मायनस फोर एस अपॉन मायनस एस, करेक्ट आहे. टीच्या जागी फोर, मायनस इथे पण टीच्या जागी फोर, ई रेस टू मायनस फोर एस अपॉन एस स्क्वेअर. दिस इज व्हॉट युअर अप्पर लिमिट, ऑल टीज आर फोर. आणि लोअर लिमिट टाकताना मध्ये निगेटिव्ह साईन द्यायचं. आणि सगळ्या टीच्या जागी काय ठेवायचं आता, झिरो, राईट. यामध्ये बोलतोय, सो एवढंच बघतो, इकडे चाललेलो नाही आपण. आधी सगळ्यात फोर ठेवलाय, निगेटिव्ह साईन देऊन सगळ्या टीला झिरो ठेवायचा. सो इथे झिरो इंटू एनिथिंग, ते झिरो होईल मायनस ई रेस टू, टीच्या जागी झिरो ठेवला, झिरो इंटू एनिथिंग इज झिरो. सो ई रेस टू झिरो अपॉन एस स्क्वेअर. This is done. The first part is done. Plus second part, 5 as it is. Upper limit for t you are writing infinity. So it is e raised to minus s into n infinity. S into infinity, infinity into anything is infinity. So this is minus of infinity upon minus s. Upper limit done. Minus lower limit is 4. So e raised to minus 4s upon मायनस एस. इथे एक मायनस, इथे एक मायनस, नंतर ठरवूयात. चलो, अपॉन मायनस एस. इज दिस क्लिअर?
येस मॅम.
येस मॅम.
राईट. सो इट इज मायनस ऑफ फोर ई रेस टू मायनस फोर एस, हा मायनस वरती जाईल, अपॉन एस. दिस मायनस एज इट इज, दिस इज झिरो. अँड व्हॉट इज ई रेस टू झिरो? डू यू नो व्हॉट इज ई रेस टू झिरो?
वन.
वन, व्हेरी गुड. 1 upon s square, right? So here it is. I'll multiply by that 5 inside. So this is negative. So plus minus become minus. 5 e raised to minus infinity. Okay, let it be here. I'll tell you. Upon s plus minus minus. This minus minus becomes?
Plus.
Plus. Outside is also plus. So it is plus 5 e raised to minus 4s. Upon s. Okay, so here I'm writing e raised to 0 is 1, and if it is e raised to minus infinity, as this is negative power, so in denominator it becomes positive, and anything raised to infinity, it is simply infinity. And what 1 upon infinity is?
0.
0.
0.
Yes, so e raised to minus infinity is 0. So can I write this directly 0 here?
Yes.
Right. So this term is zero. Okay. So now we got something. Can you please check whether everything is in S or not?
Yes, ma'am.
All the functions are in S. There is no T left. Means it just get transformed to S. T's are removed. That is called the transformer. So if we can check here, it is e raised to minus 4s upon S. E raised to minus 4s upon s. I think this is the similar term. So here it is 5, here it is minus 4. What is the total?
Plus 1.
Plus 1. So it is e raised to minus 4s upon s. And the remaining part as it is. Minus e raised to minus 4s upon s square. Plus 1 upon s square. This is your answer. Final. Laplace of f of t is this, and this is also called f of s. The whole function is of s only. That's why it is called f of s, function of s. Done. Answer. So if you can see there, t, you have to think something is wrong there, and you will check it and you will correct it. Done. Is there any doubt?
No.
Good. Today, I only focused on DSY because my student knows, regular student knows this well, what Leibniz rule and all. So my regular student now, do you understand Laplace definition?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No.
So no one is having doubt. I expect that, and we'll go to the next question. DSY, is there anyone who don't understand? Please ask. Huh? You can stop me and ask. I know thoda problem asto DSY. So you can any way stop me and ask me in between. If you think te silly ahe, mala plus minus kalat nahi, tari tumhi mala thambvani vichara. ठीक है तुम्हाला सिली वाटलं तरीही विचार चालेल
यस मॅम
गुड इज देयर एनीथिंग यू वांट टू आस्क
नो मॅम
गुड राइट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फाइंड द लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी व्हिच इज इक्वल टू ए इन 0 टू बी एंड 0 व्हेन टी इज ग्रेटर देन बी दिस इज द गिवन फंक्शन And it is asked the Laplace transform. So we should first write the definition. Please tell me the definition without looking, if you remember. Integration.
Zero to infinity e raised to minus st
f of t dt. Very good. Right. Chal. So how the integration breaks now?
Zero to b and b to infinity.
Correct. Zero to b. And greater than b means b to infinity. So here integration breaks at 0 to b and b to infinity. Both are having this into. In first part, what is the function in 0 to b?
A.
It is a. So a into dt, right? And in b to infinity, what is the function?
0
into dt. Very good. So 0 into anything?
0.
0. So zero. This answer is 0 directly, no need to solve. What about A? How is A? Is it constant?
Yes, ma'am.
Because function depends on T, there is no T. So A comes out to be constant outside the integration. From 0 to B, function is of T. So T's part will be inside the integration. This part is over. A is already out. So what is integration of E? Single function. Don't think for Leibniz. Leibniz will be only for two functions multiplied, right? So simpler. What is the integration?
E raised to minus st upon minus t.
Right. E raised to minus st upon minus s. And this is from?
0 to b.
Limits. Just the integration j. 0 to b. So they comes there. Right. Upper limit is b. A into kunacha zagevar b?
T.
T cha zagevar. Very good. So e raised to minus s into t is b first. Ani madhe negative sign? Right?
Yes.
Lower limit chadi. Right. And e raised to t 0. So 0 into anything. E raised to 0 upon minus s. That is a into e raised to minus bs upon minus s. Minus minus plus 1 upon s. 1 upon s is common from both the terms. If you want, you can take it out. A upon s, 1 upon s is out. And as it is out, here it is 1. Here it is also out. So here it is minus e raised to minus bs. Done. The answer. Is this correct?
Yes.
But this is your function of s. You can check. Oh, all are s. No t's left. A and b are okay. These are constants. Arbitrary constants. But the variable t should be removed. It should be s. Any doubt? Any question?
No, ma'am.
Good. Write the next question. Find Laplace of f of t where f of t is t minus 1 square, where t is greater than 1, and f of t is 0 in 0 to 1. Question is clear? Laplace of f of t. So we should first write formula. Integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus s t f of t dt. And this unit is not integration. Please remember this is initial part. Initial part is only integration. Ithun pude, jashe derivative che formula ahet aplyakade standard. Tashe apan Laplace che standard formula banavnar ani formulanvar solve karat janar. So he je integration ahe, that is only this part integration. आणि हे जे हवं आहे ते तुम्हाला फुरियर सिरीजला हवं आहे. सो दिस लेबनीज इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर द फुरियर सिरीज. द होल युनिट फुरियर सिरीज इज ऑन दिस लेबनीज रूल. इजंट इट? रेग्युलर स्टूडेंट्स कॅन टेल टू बीएसवाय स्टूडंट.
येस मॅम.
येस. सो होल युनिट डिपेंड्स ऑन द लेबनीज रूल इटसेल्फ. सो यू बी क्लिअर विथ दिस रूल अँड ऑल्सो द इंटिग्रेशन डेरिव्हेटिव्ह फॉर्म्युलाज. रिक्वेस्ट टू यू टू गो थ्रू द फॉर्म्युला वन्स. Chalo, so start solving. How does the function break, sir?
0 to 1 and 1 to infinity.
Are you getting everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Ita he ekatra curly bracket madhe dilele nahi. Jasa last time bollele, like this, function is this, breaks. You got it, it breaks by this curly bracket, right? But here something is not like that. Function is this in this and this in this. So then also you are getting that function breaks?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, because there are two intervals different given. Means it breaks. So how? First is 0 to 1. And second is?
1 to infinity.
1 to infinity. Right. In 0 to 1, the function is?
0.
0. And in 1 to infinity, the function is?
T minus 1 bracket square.
Right. Into dt. So 0 into anything, this is 0. Finished. And the second part is t minus 1 square into e raised to minus st dt. Please, regular student, please wait. DSY students, do you understand how to solve this integration now?
Yes, ma'am.
How do we solve this?
A minus b bracket square formula we will use first.
Okay, no need, no need. The function, whole function, if you can take derivative of that function directly, don't need to do anything for that. If we know the formula, I'll tell you the formula for that. Forget. So how can we solve this integration? Can you see two functions there multiplied?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? So this is your one function, the whole function, square function. This is first function, this is second function. Two functions multiplied together inside integration. So how can we solve?
We will take u and v.
Right, that is called Leibniz rule, right? So what is u and what is v? You have to decide that first. So let me take over this till you can think what is your u and what is v. First part is zero, so yes, gone. E raised to minus, yes, t dt. Okay, what is your u?
T minus 1 bracket square is u.
Okay.
And e minus
okay,
st.
Okay, that will be your v. You are saying that, so I'm writing. But why this is your u? So you should check that.
I have constant over there.
No, because its derivative is getting 0. You have to check that whether the derivative is getting 0 or not. Then only you can talk about Leibniz. I told you, right? Leibniz rule, u is derivable whose derivative should be 0. Then only you can call it u. Yes, jar derivative 0 zhala taras u manayache. Ma tumhala he check kara lagel ki yacha derivative 0 hotay ka. Ta tyachyasathi ek formula ahe. The formula is integration of, we need derivative, right? So I first write the derivative. What is derivative x raised to n? A regular students, what is derivative x raised to n?
N x into n.
N into x raised to n minus. Very good. So now, if it is only x, you can write this formula. Okay, yeah. Similarly, I'll write integration also. What is the integration x raised to n?
X raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1.
Yes, upon n plus 1. Now, please wait. So derivative of something raised to n. That something cannot be always x only. It can be 2x. It can be 2x plus 2. It can be 3x plus something, right? So if it is something, not just x, okay? So if it is just x, we have this. But if it is any other function than that, so it defines as n into something raised to n minus 1 into derivative of that something. Please pay attention. So if it is derivative of t minus 1 square, what will be the derivative? Something, this is your something, this is your n. N
2 into t minus
something
minus 1
raised to 2 minus 1 into derivative of this something, derivative of t minus 1. Okay, so it is 2 into 2 minus 1, 1, 2 into t minus 1 into derivative of this term. What is the derivative? Derivative, it is obviously with respect to t because the variables are t. So derivative of t is 1. What is derivative of 1?
Zero.
So its derivative is 2 into t minus 1. Are you getting the formula, dear students?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So please pay attention towards this. Derivative of x, if it is there only, like t, if it is there only, so we can go with this particular formula. But if it is something, it is a something, isn't it? It's not just t or x, it's some function of t. So go with this formula. Okay, you got the first derivative of this. What is the next derivative of this? We have to check now whether the derivative is zero or not. So what is the next derivative? 2t minus 2 will, so 2t's are 2. Minus 2 is a 0. And 2's next derivative?
0.
0.
0.
Good. So, yes, it is getting 0. That's why it is your u. Are you getting? If you can say that you will square it, t square minus 2t plus 1. Isn't it the square? That is also okay. You can square. And now you can check the derivative. What is the first derivative?
2t.
2t minus 2. 2. One's a 0. What's the derivative? 2. 2t is a derivative 2. 2 is a derivative 0. And yacha puts a derivative?
0.
So it is like 2 into t minus 1. Like this. Next is 2. Like this, and next is 0. So you will get the derivative same.
Yes, ma'am.
You can always, if you don't remember the formula, you can always square and solve. So this whole function will be your u. Chalo. So u, v are fixed. And v is what? V is simply an integrable function. Jacha integration gheta yel. Yeta aplyala each integration. Right? So this is
yes.
V. Very good. So it is, now we'll go with this. Laplace of f of t. We start with the integration. What is the integration formula you remember? U v1
minus
u dash v2
plus
u double dash
v3
minus u triple dash
u triple dash v4
plus so on. All regular students are listening now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
You are not speaking today. I'm not allowing you because of DSY student, but you are paying attention. Good. So this is the formula we have. Right? So u is there, t minus 1 square u into v1. U as it is we have written, then v1 integration of this term. Can you tell me integration now?
E raised to minus st.
Upon?
Upon minus s.
Very good. Minus s. In integration, that derivative is divides, and in derivatives, this into this is getting multiplied, right? This term, right? UV1 done. Next sign is?
Minus.
Minus U dash. Yatsa puts a derivative. We have written here derivative. So you can directly tell me now. Something raised to n. N into that something raised to n minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. No need to write. And derivative of this something is also 1. So 2 into t minus 1.
Yes,
into. Integration of this term. What is the next integration of this?
E raised to minus st.
Upon minus s. Yes, and minus 1 minus s yes is already there. Which is?
S square.
S square. Very good. Yes, minus sign. Second term is done. Next is the sign. Plus. Very good. Derivative of this term. What is the derivative?
2.
Yes. Is it 2? Everyone is agreeing?
Yes.
Plus derivative of this is 2. Right? And integration of this. Next integration of this. V3, na? That's a puts integration. So yes, that's a puts integration. What is integration?
E raised to minus st.
Yes.
Upon minus s cube.
Right. Minus s into s square minus of s cube. Completes. Next sign is negative. But the next derivative will be 0. 2's next derivative 0. So yes, it over. This is from 1 to infinity. This is extra part for your reference. As you don't know this, answer is only in one step. Can you see that? Leibniz rule giving you answer in a single step only. Whatever it is, the integration, how big it is. Chalo, so upper limit is what you are writing, upper limit? What is upper limit here?
Infinity.
Infinity. Lower limit is? 1. But this infinity you are placing on which variable?
T.
T, right? Because integration is with respect to T. So upper limit goes on T. Lower limit also goes on T. So upper limit is infinity. So if you put infinity as T here, right? All T's are infinity now. So if it is infinity here, it becomes e raised to minus infinity. What is that?
1 upon e raised to infinity.
That is what, but final outcome is?
0.
0. E raised to minus infinity is 0. So this term is 0. 0 into anything is 0. Is this 0 then? For the upper limit? Infinity? Yes. 0. What about this? In this also, if we put t is infinity, it becomes e raised to minus infinity. That is 0.
0.
And zero into anything is
zero.
What about this term? Here also you are writing t as infinity.
Yes,
e raised to minus infinity. Zero. Zero into anything is
zero.
Zero. So the whole upper limit is zero?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Upper limit done, then we give negative sign and we write the lower limit. Lower limit is 1. So t is now 1. So if it is 1 here,
it will be 0.
Right. 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 into anything, once again, it is 0.
0.
Right. If it is 0, 1 here. T is 1.
It will be again 0.
Right. 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is 0 into anything. This is 0 again. If it is 1 here, it will survive, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And what is the sign here? Plus, minus. Already okay. Sign is minus. 2. E raised to minus s
minus
into
s.
1, right?
Upon yes,
s cube. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
It is all are 0, 0, 0. Here is minus, minus becomes plus. And it is 2 upon s cube into e raised to minus s. The answer, f of s. Done. Getting, my dear students, you are getting this?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Is there any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Good. So can you just try with one homework? I'll give you one homework. Please try it. Fine. All students are getting now regular DSY. Is there any doubt to anyone?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Good. Find Laplace transform of f of t, where f of t is t minus 2 square when it is greater than 2 and is 0 in 0 to 2. Do we have time? I think no. So yes, this is your homework. Try this, find out the answer and show that the answer is 2 into e raised to minus 2s upon s cube. Okay? If you are getting, very good. If you will not get, I will solve for you. Please wait. Do not leave. I will take the attendance. Don't leave. 2 minutes. In between, if you have any doubt, you can ask me for that. And DSY students, I'm again asking you to go through formulae once, because if you know the formulae, you can solve it better. And whatever we have started, we are not going to repeat again for DSY also. We'll repeat up to the second unit or up to 2.5 unit, it will be repeat. But from this, you have to pay attention. We are not going to repeat it again. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So in your extra lecture, we'll go with the part which was not covered, but henceforth pay attention, okay? Chalo, so this is over from my side, done. Thank you. Can we stop?
Yes, ma'am.
Bye, bye.